Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be looking at how to install and set up an SDR radio on a Raspberry Pi 4. In part 1 of this series, we attempted to install and set up an SDR radio using Windows 11 for ARM. And spoiler alert, we ran into some issues with the lack of USB driver support in the ARM version of Windows. I can safely say that using Windows for ARM as the base of your Raspberry Pi SDR radio project is about as much fun as living on the top floor of an apartment block and your dog having an attack of explosive diarrhea. So what have we learnt? Well, apart from how to deep clean a pebble-dashed elevator. Well, Windows 11 on the Pi is slow and somewhat lacking. The solution is to use the Raspberry Pi OS, which, apart from requiring a reboot after installation, works extremely well. The software being used is Cubic SDR, which is running on the Pi OS. Cubic SDR is available for Windows and also for Linux. Now let's take a look at the equipment we're going to be using. So let me talk you through what you're going to need. You will need a Raspberry Pi 4, and this is a Raspberry Pi 4B 8GB model. You will need a USB extension cable, the RTL-SDR USB dongle that has an SMA connector on it, and depending on the antenna you're going to use, this adapter may be needed, which is a male SMA connector, which converts to a female BNC. And then the antenna that I'm using here is a scanner antenna rated from 20 megahertz to 1300 megahertz HF, VHF and UHF, and that has a BNC connector on it, and we can connect this all together like so, and we have the Pi, the dongle and the antenna. Now you will need to use this extension cable because the Pi's USB sockets are very close together, and if you try and put this dongle, which is quite wide, into these sockets, you will obscure the adjacent socket, and if you're using a keyboard and mouse and trying to fit this in as well, you could potentially damage these sockets trying to force them in, so definitely just buy yourself a short USB extension cable. So how much did all this cost? Well, the antenna was £11.66. The RTL SDR dongle was £30.82. The Raspberry Pi 4 8GB model was approximately £73. The Geekworm heavy duty passive cooling case was £10.82. The SD card in the rear is a 64GB SanDisk Extreme Pro, and that was approximately £9. And the adapter here plus the USB extension cable, approximately £7. So the total cost all in was £142. I will put in the description below all of the items here used, which can be purchased from Amazon. This little antenna is made by a company called Bingfu. And Bingfu is made in China, but it actually is quite a good little antenna for £11.
Bingfu.
So don't be put off by the massive wires at the back of the Pi that's currently running. That is all because of the video capture device that's required to capture the video output. So without further ado, let's push on and let's install the SDR software, which is called Cubic SDR, on the Raspberry Pi. So here we are back in the Raspberry Pi operating system. So we're going to open a terminal window and we're going to maximize this so that we can see what we're typing. So the first thing that we're going to need to do is to update the software on the Pi, and we can do that by typing in sudo apt update and wait for that process to complete. And then we'll do sudo apt full upgrade. Answer yes to that. And once that process has finished, it's usually best to do a reboot. So sudo reboot. And we'll just wait. The next thing I want to show you before we proceed any further is to show you the current overclock settings that we have on here. So sudo nano boot config.txt. And we can scroll down here and see what settings I have in here. There you go, overvoltage 4, ARM frequency 1850, and GPU frequency 650. So in line with the step one of the video, you can see what overclock settings I have on the Pi using the Pi OS versus the overclock settings I had in Windows. So to exit here, we will simply Control X. So the next command that we're going to type in is sudo and apt install, if I can spell it. Install and Cubic SDR is the name of the software. Hit enter, and that will install the packages necessary. Okay, now that has installed, I normally do a reboot at this stage just to make sure that any drivers have been loaded correctly. So I will do that now and be back in a moment. So to start the Cubic SDR software, we click on the Raspberry Pi button and we go to Other and then Cubic SDR. When the software opens, it will ask us to select the radio device that's to be used, and in this instance it's the generic RTL-2832U OEM device, and you just click on the Start button. Now I'm just going to ensure that we have muted on the right hand side, so we don't get into any trouble for broadcasting any FM radio channels which we may jump into. So at the bottom of the screen you can see the waterfall, and on the bottom right hand side there is a bar. If you move up and down that bar, you can see that you can increase the speed of the waterfall or decrease the speed as you need. The left hand side here we have bookmarks and ranges of bands. If I click on 40 meters, it will take us to predefined 40 meter bands. In the top left hand side we have the modulation. So we have FM, FM stereo, we have narrow band FM, AM, lower side band, upper side band, dual side band, and IQ. I'm not entirely sure what IQ is. The window next to it is a zoomed in view of the waterfall. On the right hand side we have the frequency that's currently selected, which is zero. The bandwidth or the width that's being monitored, which is 200 in this case here. And the center frequency relates to, on the waterfall, where the center frequency is. You can be selected and be to the left or the right of it, but that's just where the center mark is. So if I select the airband, which I'm doing here, then you'll see here that we've selected 134.675, which is the airport ATIS weather system. The band width is displayed in the top the top here, and that's how much of the bandwidth, 5000, that it's going to be picking up. And if I unmute that briefly, we should be able to hear the ATIS system.
Temperature 10, 2.4. QNH1019. Acknowledge information after on first contact.
Okay, and we'll then mute that again. So we can switch to FM radio. If I switch here, let me just... It's a little bit sluggish to use, I've noticed on the Pi. So 103.7 is a local radio station. We are muted on this one. So you can see that the bandwidth here is a lot greater. It's 200. And in the zoomed in section here, you can see that the width is much greater than the ATIS system was. And you'll need to ensure that the bandwidth is wide enough to cover what's being broadcast. I can take a bit of a risk here and see if I can unmute it. And hopefully there's no music playing.
Bingfu.
No, there is music playing. So we'll have to leave it at that. And then FM stereo will give you, proper FM stereo for the radio channel. Now, they both work, but I really can't be broadcasting these music channels. So I find that the Cubic SDR software is a little sluggish. So you may notice in the waterfall section at the bottom, if I move my mouse away, that it seems to be progressing at a very steady speed, and everything looks great, and then all of a sudden it will just stop for a second or two, and that can be quite annoying when you're trying to use your mouse to move around. So if I go back to here, and let's go back to Airband, and we should then be on 134.675, which is the ATIS system. That's better. It is quite sluggish to use. It really is.
Acknowledge information after on first contact.
As I move the mouse around the software, you'll see that it is very sluggish, and it will keep pausing as I move the mouse around. Very stuttery. It works. It's fine. You can use it, but it can be a little bit frustrating. So, in conclusion, does the SDR dongle work on the Pi and the Pi OS? Yes, it does. Was it incredibly easy to install and set up? Yes, it was. Could I use this on a day-to-day basis? No, I couldn't. Is it a pleasure to use? No. But at least it works, which is a poke in the eye for Windows. Is it good value for money? Yes. Excluding the cost of the Pi, costs about 50 quid, so you can't really go wrong with that. We have purchased a Malachite radio, which is spelt Malachite, and we're not going to ignore that, but we have purchased one. And that is a device which is handheld, contains a battery, a screen, has a waterfall, and is all band. So we have that coming, and it's around the same money that you're going to pay for the Pi setup that we were looking for. So we'll be seeing if that is a better alternative than to progress on and to build our own enclosure to house this particular SDR solution. Well, that's it for this initial look at SDR radio. And please stay tuned for the Mala, hopefully not shite, radio review, which will be coming up soon. Please like this video and subscribe to the channel, as it really does help me out. If you've been using the Raspberry Pi as an SDR radio, then please share your experiences in the comments below. Have you had a better experience with other dongles and software? I'd be interested in hearing from you. So until next time, all the best and take care.